You know, those of us who have woken up, and I'm not talking about woke, I'm talking about awake, really awake. And there's different levels, but I'm talking about those of us who have woken up to the extreme level. We are still, why are we left here? I mean, why would God wake us up? Why would we wake up to the extreme and be left here? The only reason to be left here is to wake other people up. That's the only reason. And I promise you, once a person wakes up, really wakes up, their only goal is, yeah, you got to make a living. Yeah, you want to get out of debt. You want to eat and take care of your health, take care of your stuff. But their overarching goal is to wake people up, the masses. One example that you know everybody's sleeping is, not everybody, but you know a lot of people are asleep because the deceptions are so great, it just boggles the mind, you know? I think somebody left something in my car. Kind of smells like cigarettes or something. I don't know what it is. But here's one example of the Decepticon that's so great it boggles the mind. So you got people like Alex Jones trying to wake people up, saying he's waking people up. I'm waking people up to the New World Order. Well, that's a lie, because it's always been here. The god of this world is the devil. All the nations are deceived by the devil. All the cultures are cults, your cult. The New World Order started in Genesis 3. Babylon. God split up Babylon, but he's sitting there saying, we're fighting the New World Order. But the reality is, the harder you fight, the more it culminates. And they know this. The higher ups know this. Here's what the higher ups know. They know now that no matter what they do, there is a... No matter what they do, no matter what decision they make, whether it's peace, whether it's fighting, whether it's war, whether it's lies, whether it's truth, whether it's whatever, that it's to the point now to where they can actually see the singularity. They can actually see it. The high level Gnostics, high level witches, high level UFO people, high-level gurus, they all know this. That the singularity is inevitable. There's nothing they can do to stop it. No matter what decision they make, it's headed this way. And the ones who use their brain, they can see it. There's no way to stop it. The only way that they could stop the singularity is have a nuclear bomb the whole world, you know. Because the Bible is very clear. Knowledge will increase. Wars and rumors of wars. When you communicate with somebody, it doesn't matter who it is. If two people are communicating honestly with truth, via the truth, if they're honest and they talk back and forth, I mean, if they've got a brain, you know, if they got some kind of brain, if somebody was really honest about, are they a sinner? They'd have to admit they're sinners if they really talked about it, but they don't want to hear all that. If somebody was really honest about Jesus being God, they'd have to conclude, because Jesus, the Logos, is logical. Logos means logic. The Logos is logical. So if you had somebody who was communicating with you in truth, you're going to hit source code. When you face off with the Bible, you're going to hit source code. When you face off with etymology, you're going to hit source code. When you face off with math, science, engineering, anything, you're going to hit source code if you really, whether you're a doctor, nurse, whether you're an architect, no matter what, you're going to hit the foundation, the source code, the cornerstone. No matter which way you look at it, the cornerstone is Jesus. I don't care what kind of field of study you're in, or education or job or whatever, you're going to hit source code, which is Jesus. There's no way to escape it. Jesus is the singularity. Jesus is the singularity, and the Antichrist has no choice but to use the word Christ, Christ consciousness or whatever. It's an anti, but the singularity is non, it can't be stopped. It's going to happen. It's inevitable. It's inevitable. History had a bunch of variables at one point, but now it's gotten to the point where the variables are being diminished exponentially. And so now they can actually see what's going to happen in the future. You can see the legalism encroaching. You can see the flesh mind encroaching. You can see the nations, the internal conflict in the nations. You can see the differences of opinions becoming more extreme. The divide, the sheep and the goat, you can see the big division is happening more and more as we approach. You can see technology being tied into the human. You can see the whole game. If you just sit down and meditate on it, it's inevitable. Just like that movie where that guy snapped his finger and says, "I'm inevitable." The beast. Now maybe that's why he wanted to destroy half the universe, because he knew that man would destroy himself. Jesus comes back to destroy those that would destroy the earth. And so man will destroy himself if God doesn't intervene. Let me say that again. Mankind will destroy himself unless God intervenes. Because the logic of mankind is upside down. Bible says you're saved by faith, you walk by faith. But they don't want to do that. They walk by sight, and they try to figure it out in their own power and their own strength, even though it's right in front of you. Everything's already, you've got everything you need, the water, breathing. The Bible talks about a great constriction. The great tribulation, the word in the Greek is constriction. And so there's a great constriction. They were already started with their viruses leaking out of their laboratories and all that. The great constriction, right? Speaking of that, great constriction. Get you some garlic for 10 days. Cut it up, let it sit 10 minutes, then throw it in your soup or whatever. Do that for 10 days straight and see what happens. Two of the bulbs of garlic, cut it up, let it sit for 10 minutes. The allicin starts up, then you throw it in your food, you eat it, and do that for 10 days, see what happens. Onions and garlic. Onion soup, garlic soup, whatever you need to do. Let's see if you don't feel better. I promise you, you've been lied to. And so, when Alex says, we're fighting the New World Order, it's already been here. It's always been, and it's not going away until Jesus rules. Who do you think runs this thing? If there's Jesuits in every country, if there's Masonic, if there's Masons in every country, if there's witches in every country, if there's covens everywhere, if there's the magician priest class in every country, who runs this place? And anybody who speaks up, like the president, they took him out and he said this secret society, military industrial complex, whatever it is, he said, they took him out. They shot him. They give you the red versus blue to make you think you have a choice. You don't have a choice. And they create so much drama and so much division and so much pain and misery and death and war and all that, that they make you so angry that you blind yourself because of your revenge and because of your bitterness and all that. You actually blind yourself to really what's going on. And they know this. They throw it on the news. They put it in your eye gate. They put it in your ear gate to turn you into a copy of them, to make you bitter and worried and fearful and angry and revengeful and all that stuff. That's what they're doing. It's the devil's system. And they get on the microphone and say, we got to fight the New World Order. You got to get mad. You got to, these devils, we're going to take them out. And I hope I never see them. Blah, 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 blah. They're part of they're attacking your soul and you don't even know it. They act like they're, this is how deep it is. They act like they're on your side, but they're attacking your soul. They act like they're on your team, but they're actually attacking your heart and your mind and your soul. And they're giving you a reality that doesn't even exist, because the New World Order's already been here, and it's always been here since Babylon, Babel, Genesis 3, hath God said. It's actually the flesh mind of man. Man does it to himself. Instead of being mad at the New World Order, be mad at your old flesh mind. Be mad at your old Adamic nature. And you know he's a liar because he supports the Book of Enoch, or he supports the post-tribulation rapture. Anybody who supports the post-trib is confused, because that's not faith alone. That's a works-based system. Now, do I listen to them sometimes? Yeah, because I like to see what's up with the news, and I like to, you know, see what the Democrats are trying, what other lie they're trying to do. But I really don't listen to him much anymore. I listen to other people, but I already know their lies, and there's nothing new. What has been shall be. That they don't have anything to do. What's my story? What's my point in all this? My point is that the deception's so great, they pretend to be your friend, but they're attacking your soul. They pretend to be your best friend, but they're actually attacking your spiritual well-being. And they're paid actors. They're paid actors, and they're all working together. And you thought it was real. It was all a show. It was all fake. Wasn't real at all.